final is applicable for variable, class and method. Okay, if variable as a final, we cannot change the value. If you are using class as a final, then we cannot inherit. So we can use final as a three level in the Java. One is your class level, one is your method level, one is your variable level. So how I am explaining, you have to explain like that. I am giving the notes also, right? So someone will ask what is the final modifier, then you have to explain like that one. Okay, so if you will write final class, then what happened? We cannot perform the inheritance concept. If you will write final as a method, we cannot overwrite that method. If you will write final as a variable, we cannot change this value. So this is your final. So someone will ask where we can use final, right? So some of the class is there, the others developer don't want to inherit that. Okay, then we will use final class. Some logic is there, that logic other developer can't, means some requirement is there, that logic will not override, yet that logic will not change at all. So in the real time we will use their final variable, method, variable, final, right? Bank is a class, bank class is there, IFSC code, right? So someone cannot be modified that variable, so that place we will use in the real time final step. Okay, so we have a final modifier. Final is a modifier applicable for class, method and variable. Final method, if parent class method is declared as a final, we cannot override that method in child class because it implementation is final. So what I want to tell you here, this is class. If you will write the final, then what happened? Method, then we cannot override that method. If you will try to override that method, then we'll get compile time error. So this is your one class is there. We have a method M1 and M2. So this is method is also present inside this subclass. I've written this method as a final. If you will try to modify this, then you can see what happened. You will get compile time error. So M2 is cannot be override in the final. Okay, so that's why we are getting this, because method is final. Compiler is already overridden, method is final. So we cannot override this if you are using final. Okay, so same thing. Class, final class. If a class declare as a final, we cannot extend the functionality of that class. That is, we cannot create a child class for that class. That is, inheritance is not possible for the final class. Okay. So, if you will use this. Okay, this class as a final. Okay, I'm trying to first I will save this class. Okay, so I'm trying to extend this class, then what happened? This session is recorded, right? A lot of people are not there. So you can see cannot inherit. So if you are using final, we cannot inherit. Okay, I think I cannot add. Okay, so final we So here I have written every method present inside the final class is always final by default, but every variable present inside the final class need not to be a final. What do you meaning of that? Every method present inside this final, okay, is always final. Means if you have a every method present inside this final class, one final class is there, is always final, but every variable present inside this final class need not to be a, we have a one final class in any method is there inside this, it will become the final, but variable cannot be, okay. So but every variable present inside this final class need not be a final. So just I have given the summary. Final method cannot be override, final class cannot be extend, and final variable cannot be changed. What is the advantage of this? Why we are using the final modifier in the real time? The main advantage of the final keyword, we can achieve the security, we can provide the unique implementation, but we have a disadvantage of the final as well. We are missing the key benefits of the OOP concept like inheritance because of final, polymorphism because of final. Hence, if there is no specific requirement, then it is not recommended to use. If you will go in the implementation, you know, application implementation, so we have to some of the place means the class cannot be inherit, some of the place cannot, method cannot be override, some of the place variable cannot be changed, then only we can use. We cannot use frequently as a final, otherwise we cannot do this OOP concept, right, inheritance and polymorphism. So final versus abstract, actually abstract class I do not discuss, just I will give you a little bit idea about abstract class. What do you meaning of abstract, right? I already discussed, but again I will go through this abstraction, right? I have discussed the abstraction. So how to achieve the abstraction? By using the interface, abstract class and abstract method. Three things: interface, abstract class and abstract method. What is interface? Interface, you know, when I'll give you one example, we have a vehicles, right? So just I will create a interface as a vehicles, and vehicles having features, right? Like we have a different vehicles. So inside this vehicles, whatever the features is there, we will declare inside this interface. Why interface? Someone will ask, why interface? So just I will go through the little bit definition. So interface is a fully unimplemented class which is used to declare some set of an operation. Unimplemented means there is no implementation inside this interface, only declaration is there. Declaration means only abstract method is there, okay. So vehicles and subtype of the vehicles is what? Bike is there, bus is there, right? Subtype of the bus, we have also the different type of the buses, we also have a different type of the you know, bike. So some features I have given inside this, like we have a headlights, brakes, and what else? Okay, two things I have given, right? Why we will use abstract class? So abstract class is a fully unimplemented class which is used to declare some set of operation which is common to all next level of the subclass. What do you meaning of this? Vehicles having you know, two brakes, any vehicles, right? So this is the common implementation for all subclass type. Bike have also the different subtype, right? Okay, and buses also having the different subtype. So this is, you know, abstract class means we are providing the common implementation. I have implemented in one vehicles like brakes, I implemented inside this abstract class, so which is common for all next level of the subclass. Whatever I am telling you, when I will start the interface, I will give you the code, okay. So just I want to, what do you meaning of the abstract means hiding. This is, you know, the coding thing I have discussed. Now we'll come with English word. I am going to to add her. I'm already late. Have to call once, right? So I can't do anything. We are already late. I already pinged in the group these guys. So I told you in that coding interface abstract class, but if you will go in the English language, abstraction means hiding, means we are hiding the implementation. What is the meaning of the hiding the implementation? I have declare inside this interface, right? I have provided the declaration. You know, I'm using the bike. I don't know how they have implemented the brake. I am using the bike, right? Headlights. Okay, I am using the headlights. Brake, I am using the brake, right? Right. So I don't know how they have implemented. That is called hiding. Declaration is there. I am the user only using this. That is called abstract class or abstraction. Okay, so that implementation or declaration I have given, I don't know how to they have implemented this. I am the user, just I am going to use this. Okay, that is the meaning of abstract. But if you will go only for English word, we are not able to understand in the code, in code. So when you will implement some code and then will relate to the real time, then you will understand. Okay, that is the meaning of abstraction. English having the different meaning and coding having the different meaning, but if we will go completely in the code and understand this, then we are able to understand the words. Okay, like ATM machine. In ATM machine, I don't know how they have implemented. Just I have a card, I inserted this and whatever amount you want and pin number, how it is working internally, I don't know. That is called abstraction. But don't give this type of the example without coding. Like you, if someone will ask what is the abstraction, you have to relate with interface or abstract class or abstract method. If you will give this type of the definition, definitely they will ask they will not satisfy your answers. Okay, so this is the thing, like the people are discussing, but it is not the thing in the real time, right? But English word is same in coding and in real time. Okay, so abstract method compulsory we should override to the class to provide the implementation. We have abstract class, right? I told you we have to provide the implementation. Implementation means we have to override that method, right? Okay, so I will give you this code. Okay, you are able to understand when I will start the interface. Whereas we cannot override the final method. We cannot override, we cannot implement. So abstract and final is not applicable. Final abstract combination is illegal combination of all method. For final class, we cannot create a child class where the abstract to be, when we are going to do the implementation, means we are providing the inheritance concept. So final is not applicable. Someone will ask, why, what if you will give abstract combination of abstract and final, so you have to explain them. Your explanation will come, we have a abstract method. So abstract method means declaration inside this interface. When we are going to declare this abstract method, then how to implement, we have to override this method. Then if you will declare right abstract method or abstract class, then we cannot override and we cannot extend, right? I told you subclasses, they call subclasses. So for abstraction we need interface, we need abstract method, abstract class, inheritance, polymorphism, loose coupling, or dynamic method dispatching, means dynamic banding. So when you are implementing your interface, so all this concept will come in inside this one code. I will start the interface again, I will discuss all the point. Okay, I think you got some idea about of this abstract class can contain final method, whereas abstract class cannot contain method. What is meaning of this? We have abstract class. Inside this we can write this final, but we have a final class, we cannot write inside this abstract. So these are the things they are asking in the interview. Okay, can I write the abstract as a final? If you will write, you will tell no. They will ask the reason why we cannot write. Then you have to tell, if I will write abstract method as a final, what happened? They will ask, you will tell no simply, they will not satisfy with your answer. You have to tell, if you will write this, then how to implement this? How to override this? So next topic is your class and types of the classes. So these are the types of the classes, okay? We have our interface. Why it is the type of the classes? Because it is a root level, it is like a class only. Interface is like a class, okay? So it is a root level of the class. Abstract class, concrete class, final class, enum and annotation. So we'll discuss three, okay? These two are not required, okay? So we'll understand what is an interface. Do you have any idea about an interface, anyone? Any real time example of the interface? Might be interviewer will ask, what can you, definition is, you can make your definition, okay, if you will understand the concept. Why interface is required? Why interface is required? You can tell whatever you have a knowledge, you can tell, you can explore your knowledge. If you will speak more, then this habit will help you in exam, because you are doing same thing. I am asking the question, you are giving the answer. But whatever the things you are like, you doing the mistake here in the interview, you will give the correct answer. Okay. So why, my question is, why interface? What is the use?
To provide structure. For example, a bank has to open multiple branches. It will define that you should have an IFSC code, you should have web security, you should have native security, but the implementation will be sheerly managed by the branches only. It will provide the structure.
Okay. Anyone can? Others?
Through the interface only we can do multiple inheritance, but through the classes we cannot have multiple inheritance.
Okay. Good. Okay. So we'll understand first why interface. Okay. You can see we are using the web driver is an interface. Okay. So this web driver is an interface. I'll tell you why interface is required. Okay. Okay, so first we'll go through definition, okay, and then we'll come on this. Definition is, interface is a fully unimplemented class, okay, which is used to declare some set of operation. Okay, interface is a fully unimplemented class. What is meaning of fully unimplemented class? So we have a interface here, right? Interface, I'm not writing all the things, just for understanding purpose. Interface, web driver. Okay, web driver. This is interface. My definition is, interface is a fully unimplemented class. Why I am telling the class? Interface is a class. I'm not telling the behavior of the class interface having the different features, but it is a root level of the class. If you will go in the documentation of Java, they have already mentioned it is a type of the class. Okay, so we'll search on the documentation of code Java, means it will come in that is Oracle. So I'll send you the link, okay, later. So unimplemented class. So what do you meaning of unimplemented class? This is the interface and this is the web driver. Unimplemented means we are providing the operation. Okay, unimplemented means we are providing the operation. What do you meaning of the operation? Actually, web driver and all, we are using this. Okay, they have implemented, we are using. I told you now, we are the users. Okay, oh, I cannot copy paste here. Okay, so here we have a method call. I'll tell you, we have a method call close, right? Close. Okay. What do you meaning of abstract class? Abstract method. Method does not have a body. That is called abstract class. Okay, why we are using the abstract class? For declaring the operation. So when I am going to implement this web driver, we have a set of operation, right? How many operation we have? You can see we have a find element, get method, you know, get title, get window handles, manage, navigation, quit and switch. You know why it is an interface, I'm telling you. Okay, so what is meaning of this? So we are using the API, right? They already implemented, we are using. We are not able to see this implementation. I having the source code, I will show you this web driver implementation, but we are using this. So my one line of the definition is interface is a fully unimplemented class. So how they have implemented this, that thing I want to show you. Okay, fully unimplemented class. What are other methods we have? Where it is? Get method, get title, just I'm not taking all. Okay, get title. So interface is a fully unimplemented class which is used to declare some set of operation. Okay, these are the operation. How to declare this operation? By using abstract method. Okay, this, you know, I have a requirement. Who developed this web driver, they think if I will automate this web application, what the navigation we have to require, right? So when you are going to do manual testing, then all the, you know, they think, oh, we have to launch this browser, then we have to close this browser, we have to refresh this browser, they have this is the requirement. This is nothing but operation. Okay, so how they have implemented? So we'll come in the definition. So interface is a fully unimplemented class. I am not providing any implementation inside this interface, only declaration operation I have provided. Okay, why we are providing the operation? She joined or not? Okay, so leave it. My flow is okay. So why operation? You know, operation means whatever the requirement is there. Whatever the requirement is there, right? So these are the operation. So that's why they took interface. We are not providing any implementation, only declaration. Declaration means operation. Operation means in the code Java we are using abstract method. Okay, so we'll come again with definition. Interface is a fully unimplemented class which is used to declare some set of an operation. How to create an interface? By using the interface keyword. Inside this interface, I'm using Java 1.8. 9, 10, 11, 12 also came. Some changes are there. Okay, so leave it at changes. Okay, someone will ask in the interview and they will ask in the any new point, just you have to tell I use Java 1.8. Okay, some changes are there. Okay, so inside this interface, what you can write? So we can write the method and we can write the variable. Okay, two things we can write. Method is always, you know, abstract method, and variable is always final. What is this? One second. Yes, what you can write. Okay, this is a simple code of this interface. So interface, inside this we have a variable, we have abstract method. If you are not writing, you know, public static final, by default compiler will add. If you are not writing public abstract method, by default compiler will add. So first, why interface, right? What is interface? Why interface? Because we are, you know, we have a operation. So how to implement that operation, then we will go through the interface. Again I will come, why you will get slowly. Okay, so what is the interface? Interface is a fully unimplemented class, means there is no implementation, right, which is used to declare some set of operation. Here just I have given the dummy code, right? I have given this operation, some set of an operation. Okay, inside the interface, what is applicable? If we can declare variable and we can declare abstract method. So if you are not giving this final variable as a public static and final, by default compiler will add. If you are not declare public or abstract method, by default compiler will add. Interface, what else the other point of the interface? So what is an interface and what you can declare inside this interface? We cannot create instance of an interface. Okay, means you cannot create an object of an interface. Okay, so I think you got some little bit idea what of interface. So I will go through this definition. Interface is a fully unimplemented class used for declaring a set of an operation and object. It is created by using keyword interface. It is always created as a root class in the object creation process. It contains only public static final variable and abstract method. Okay, so someone will ask, but what is an interface? Then you have to tell all the points with example, otherwise they will not understand your word. Okay, you can search in the Google, you will get lot of the things, lot of the definition, but we should go for the concept. So different type of the vehicles we have, a you know, vehicles. Now I am going for the implementation. What do you meaning of this implementation? And I'll show you. We have interface WebDriver. You can see all known implementing class. These are the all classes implementation of WebDriver. Okay, so we have a Chrome driver, we have a Edge, this event, pairing, Firefox, Internet Explorer, Opera, remote web driver, Safari. So I have given the declaration, right? I have given the declaration. If you will implement all these classes, you know, all the operation we can implement inside this, right? Got it, what I want to tell you. Inside the interface only operation is there. Might be this is having the 10 operation. If you will go in the web element, more operation is there, right? So 10 operation is there. Now I am going to implement different type of the subclasses. Okay, so same thing I have written here, different type of the vehicles. bus, car, bike, and different implementation of the vehicles, different type of the animal, lion, tiger, elephant. So these are the dummy example. Okay, I'm relating with web driver. Okay, so if you will, someone will ask, relate with your Selenium, all the codes, whatever the Java you are learning, relate with Selenium. Okay, so in one shot you are not able to understand. If you will think and if you will read the theory and if you will execute the code on your system, then slowly you will grab the concept. If you will once grab the concept, you will never forget this, right? Because you know the concept, you can explain in your English language, no problem. Okay, so these are the simple code I have given inside the interface. What is going to happen? We have abstract class. What do you meaning of the abstract class? We are providing the partial implementation. What do you meaning of the partial implementation? We can provide the abstract method, we can provide the concrete method, we can provide the block also, we can provide the constructor also, we can provide the block, what else? That's it. Okay, that's why it is called the partial implemented class. Okay, so why we are using abstract class? Because we are providing the common implementation. We have Chrome driver, Firefox driver, right? All these browsers are there. We have some common implementation. Like I am taking the dummy one example, refresh. After implementing all this operation, I want to refresh all the browsers. Okay, that refresh operation will implement inside this abstract class. So we should not provide the implementation for all the classes. Got it, right? If I will implement one common implementation inside this abstract class, we should not give the implementation for the other classes. Got it? Okay, so that's why we are using abstract class. So it is a partial implemented class used for developing some of the operation of an object which are common for all next level of the subclass. It is declared using the abstract modifier. It contains abstract method and concrete method. It contains variable, block and constructor. It is created as a subclass to subclass next to interface. Okay, I'm stopping your session. I'm very tired today, but